Ukrainian Air Force saying Russia has fired an intercontinental ballistic missile in the central eastern city of Dnipro. If true, this would be the first known use of these powerful nuclear-capable missiles. And this as the U.S. Embassy in Kyiv has reopened following an urgent warning that Russia might launch a significant air attack on the capital city. Tensions remain high in the region after Ukraine used long-range British missiles and American-made ballistic missiles to strike Russian territory for the first time. President Biden also expanding Ukraine's arsenal by agreeing to give the country anti-personnel landmines.
The landmines that we would look to provide them would be landmines that that are not persistent. You know, we can control when they would self-activate, self-detonate, and that makes it far more safer eventually than the things that they are creating on their own.
John Elliott is the former Trump national security aide and author of the new book, The Biden-Harris Betrayal, Weak and Woke on the World Stage. And John, now, John, good morning to you. So how big of a deal is this news that Ukraine is saying that Russia has fired an intercontinental ballistic missile for the first time?
Well, Carly, good morning. It's absolutely a big deal if it's true, just as you said. What this is, this would represent a major escalation by Russia in the war against Ukraine. And this follows on what the Biden administration did just the last couple days. They allowed for attacks directly, long-range attacks, 130, 190 miles, up to 190 miles into the territory of Russia. That's never been authorized before. These are U.S. weapons that are now authorized to go directly against Russia. And then also what Lloyd Austin was just saying there about the anti-personnel mines, those have never been given over there. And those are very, very dangerous. Once again, that's a major escalation. So if true, this ICBM that was launched for the first time against Ukraine, this would mean a major escalation, really a response to the provocation that the Biden administration is doing in the last throes. We got 2 months going in this administration. President Trump has said that he's going to ramp this war down. And suddenly, why are we provoking the Russians and then having a tit for tat? Meantime, there's more going on in Iran that we can talk about. But we're on the verge of World War III in two locations on the Biden-Harris watch. And it's coming in the last 2 months before President Trump gets in office. And this is outrageous.
Okay, so also Vladimir Putin just lowered the threshold for the country to be allowed to use nuclear weapons. Their current stance is essentially they could use nuclear weapons if they're attacked at any time. So where do you think all of this is going?
Well, once again, this is we're on the verge of World War III right now because we are. Putin has said that there was a red line. He said that if we allow Ukraine to attack directly long range missiles into Russian territory, then that was a red line and that he threatened nuclear action as a result of that. And look, we also have the.
Hey, shalom, shalom. All praises, honor, glory goes to Yah Bashmah Shai Bashim Rachak Wadash. Double honors to the apostles, elder bishop, the great millstone, Ruel. Peace and blessings to you fellow brothers pushing out this word and truth and sincerity. Coming back with another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh. Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rechak, Wadash. And basically the Heavenly Father's red line has been crossed. Okay, the Heavenly Father's red line has been crossed. Because who's controlling these nations? Let me get a scripture. And this is all... new tab. This is all fair use. Let's go to Proverbs 21. The Heavenly Father is controlling everything. Okay, Yah Bashem Yahushai. And his red lines have been crossed. And he's drawing these nations together for battle, Armageddon. Okay, Proverbs, and this is not going to be a long lesson. Proverbs 21, Lord's will, Proverbs 21 and 1. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. So this is why major escalations, and we've been speaking about escalations. I remember doing multiple videos from the start of this war, even the escalations with the Israeli, Iran, Hamas, Lebanon, Houthi war, okay, that's going on a different front. We've been speaking about escalation, and the first ever ICBM has been launched, intercontinental ballistic missile. Now, what Russia did, they didn't use a nuclear warhead, but they used a capable ICBM that has the ability to attach a nuclear warhead as another, you know, buffer, if you will, to tell the West that, hey, look, we're ready to shoot missiles. We're ready to use nuclear missiles. Okay, so the first ever ICBM, intercontinental ballistic missile, was shot. Okay, because Russia didn't have to shoot an intercontinental ballistic missile. They didn't have to do that. They could have shot another type of long-range missile, you know, with 300 or 400 mile radius or distance. They shot a missile to where it can reach United States. It can reach Europe. It can reach the UK. Okay, and why are these things happening? Well, I got a scripture. And you can see him. Esau's very worried. Look at it. Let's look at some of these comments. Let's see. Let's see what's the temperature of the people. It says Biden is fully responsible for this escalation, which he's not. He's just a figurehead that people can point and blame, you know, but you have people behind the scenes, but really it's the Heavenly Father. And we're going to get into why, okay, really ultimately, and we've been speaking about it, the Most High, he wants to destroy America, okay? He wants to take out the wicked in rulership, okay? The administration intentionally escalated this situation. They need to be held accountable for this and so many other crimes committed against American citizens. Okay, and really all this is going into because what you have done to the Israelites, and we're going to get that. This is all blowback from what the Edomites have done, your ancestors, what you have done, you know, obtaining this land and the different acts of violence that you have committed against the Israelites, the so-called Black, Hispanic, Native Americans, and what you do behind the scenes this very day, okay? Also going around looting, going around getting people drunk off the philosophies of Babylon the Great, pushing the homosexual agenda, the happy people agenda, you know, pedophile rings, all that. Okay, this is pretty much the blowback from them. This is the payback. Everyone who voted for Kamala voted for this. But let me go to, I want to go to Joel. Is it Joel? Let me see. Give me a second. Zephaniah 3. Right, Zephaniah 3. And, yep, in 8. It says, therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. And this is the Lord rising up to the prey.
Iranians who are 1 month away from building several nuclear weapons right there. And so this is once again the instability that's brought about through the Biden-Harris weakness. We saw it in Afghanistan. There was a green light for Putin to go 2 years ago into Russia.
And it looked like he got some plastic surgery done too.
Years ago now. And so this is something where Russia is right on the edge right now. And this is something that we need President Trump in office right away so that he can ramp down these conflicts and just bring peace.
And President Trump is not going to ramp down. Maybe it might calm down a little bit, but things are going to escalate. It's going to continue to escalate, major escalations. Have things slowed down? Absolutely not. Because what? Let's read it. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations. The Lord's determination. Let's look up the word determination, not even in a blue letter. Firmness or purpose. Resoluteness. Okay, resolution, resolve, will, power, strength of will. And the Lord, he's the strongest in the universe. nothing goes against his will. So people are like, well, why is this happening? How can they let this happen? Why don't they want peace? Well, the Heavenly Father doesn't want peace. Okay, he wants war. Let me get that. Okay, and see, you got you individuals, you people here in the world, you getting ready to you're getting ready to experience the Heavenly Father, all right, and his anger and his mannerisms and through judgment. What is it? Exodus 3 and I don't remember the scripture. Yeah, Exodus 15, that's what it is. Exodus 15 and 3. Exodus 15 and 3. The Lord Yahweh is a man of war, and like the Father, so is the Son. The Lord Yahweh, Bashem, is a man of war. The Lord Yahweh is his name. Okay? And this is why has there been so many wars throughout the ages? Because this is how the Heavenly Father gets down. All right. He brings nations together to fight against each other. Okay. And it's really ultimately judgment. But the ultimately the Heavenly Father's his grand scheme is for there to be peace on earth. And see, this is what you heathen nations and 2/3 of our people don't understand, that, yeah, it is violence now, but this is because wickedness is in the earth. Wickedness is allowed to prosper. So when wickedness prospers, what does the Most High do? He takes you out. Okay, these people that are dying in these wars, what the scriptures say, whoever perish being innocent. So these soldiers that get drawn into these wars and die in these wars, that's ultimately judgment for the crimes that they have committed. And see, this is what the powers of be don't want to let you know. All right, they're saying that you have free will. Da, 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 da. Nah, there is no free will. Let me continue. For my determination is to gather the nations that I may assemble the kingdoms. Is this not happening? To pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. When those nuclear missiles, okay, when those nuclear missiles get shot off, okay, that's it. All right, there is, that's it. And the Heavenly Father's spirit is going to be in those missiles. And the Lord's determination, okay, is to gather you nations together to fight against each other. And there's so, let's go to Joel, the third chapter. Okay. This is why these things are happening. If you didn't know, now you know. Well, let me go to Isaiah 34. Because you should be listening to the prophets. Okay. Really, that's really who you should be listening to. And we've been speaking about since our apostles been speaking about it 30, 40 years. And then their elders before them. So this thing been going out, but mainly on the internet since 2007. And you individuals, you scoffed at it. You scoffed at ICBMs. Now the first ever ICBM has been launched. Now there is no nuclear warhead on it, but that was an act of what they call deterrence. They're basically signaling to the U.S. and I was watching. I believe that was it's one of these war analysts. Might have been Colonel McGregor or Scott Ritter or one of them analysts were basically saying like what they're going to do. They're going to shoot from the sources that they had, and it came true. They're going to shoot an ICBM, a nuclear capable missile, a nuclear capable projection. Missile basically without the warhead, signaling to the West, basically NATO and America, that we're ready to shoot nuclear missiles. Okay, we're ready. This is an ICBM. We don't need a UI. We could have shot a drone. We could have shot a different type of missile. Okay, but they got an ICBM. It could have been hypersonic as well. Who knows? Hey, the scriptures say, thy people shall be willing in a day of thy power. Watch when these things start to come to pass. Watch how things shift. Watch how the spirit of the earth is getting ready to shift. Okay, because the Heavenly Father's red lines have been passed and the people have not hearkened. Okay, Isaiah 34:1. And I can see us getting brought to the magistrates, brought to these different courts, brought to the leaders. And they're going to be like, what the hell is going on? And the Lord's going to give us a mouth to speak his words. But we're speaking them now, and you're not hearkening. Isaiah 34:1. All these fucking games that you people have been playing, it's over. All these games are over with. Okay, come near ye nations to hear and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear and all that is therein, the world and all things that come forth of it. Okay, all you individuals down here on the earth. Okay. Hearken, all right. Listen to the word of the Lord, but of course you're not going to. You think you're gonna ride off into the sunset, but those terrors are gonna come upon you suddenly. Okay, we're gonna rejoice in these times. Okay, this is a very exciting time for the hopeful elect. Okay, because our salvation is nearer than when we believe, as Romans 13:11 says. So the basically what's happening is the Lord is closing up shop. The Lord is closing up shop, man. He's about to fuck you people up. Okay, verse 2. For the indignation, that's the righteous anger. The Heavenly Father tells you in, what is that? Is that Isaiah? Not Isaiah. Let me get that. Revelation, the 19. Blue letter. Revelation, the 19. Revelation 19. Give me a sec. I had it. That's right there. Revelation 19:11. Let me give me a sec. I'm sipping on some tea. This is licorice. Okay, licorice and cayenne pepper. Cayenne pepper is a very great stimulant. A very great stimulant to, and it's really a food for the heart. Okay, gets blood flowing, gets things opening, it stimulates digestion. Licorice, it coats, it feeds the adrenals. So it helps you get over like adrenal fatigue or chronic fatigue syndrome. Okay, it's great for digestion and coats the digestive system all the way down to the colon to patch it up. We can go on. This is not a video about herbs, but I can go on about it. Give me a second. Okay, Revelation 19:11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse. Now, see, this is pretty much World War III. Missiles are flying to America. Yahawashi is going to come out of the clouds. Okay, that's that white horse. That's the heaven opening. Okay, he's going to come from the fourth dimension, for lack of better words. And he that sat upon him was called faithful and true, meaning he that was controlling the chariot. And in righteousness, he does judge and make war. So we read in Exodus 15:3 how Yahweh, and when you say Yahweh, you got to bring in Yahweh Shai. Okay, so Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai? They are men of war. Okay, but in righteousness, he does judge. So they judge in righteousness, and they make war in righteousness. Okay, the war that's being waged between these different nations, unrighteous wars. Okay, the wicked elite are trying to control the narrative. They're trying to control the war. They even say all wars are bankers' wars. Okay, all these modern wars are bankers' wars. And ultimately, it's because the greed of these different nations. And Esau, ultimately, he wants to push the MOTB. So we know that missiles are not going to be flying to America, and America's not going to be completely destroyed. Now, there could be explosions. There could be, small tactical nuclear weapons that can be launched, but it's not going to be all out. America's going to be destroyed. Why? Because we understand that the MOTB has to be pushed. Okay. And ultimately, these wicked elite, they do want a war to knock out a large population of the earth, and then for everybody else to fear and then be, agree to take the MOTB as salvation. Okay, but the point is that Yahweh Shai, they judge and make war righteously in righteousness. So going back, right? The indignation is the righteous anger. So the judgment has come into particularly America. To hell with everybody everywhere else, especially the land of Israel, yeah. But the whole world's getting ready to be judged. The earth is going to rock to and fro. There's going to be famine. It's going to be bad in all the earth. But mainly here in America, the Most High is really about to fuck this place up, because that's where the Heavenly Father's righteous anger is pointed towards. Okay, really, because what you have done to his people. And we're going to get that. I thought that was in Zephaniah, but I think we read that in Zephaniah. Right, that's why the Lord told us to wait upon him, because this is, he wants to do this. And see, we're blameless. We're not sending no missiles. We don't hit no buttons. We're not in conflict with any of these nations. Okay, we are outside. We're outside. Okay, we're basically the commentators. Right, the commentator. Why would you get mad at the commentator? Okay, why would you get mad at the newscaster? Okay, which is synonymous with the prophet. But in this case, we're already telling you what's getting ready to happen. And now the first ICBM is being launched. But there is no, it's not nuclear tipped. Okay, for the indignation or the righteous anger is upon of the Lord is upon all nations, and his fury upon their armies. He has utterly destroyed them. He has delivered them to the slaughter. And so there's going to be a great slaughter. There's already individuals in wars right now, these different fronts that are just being, I was watching a video. I mean, it's like graphic. I'm like, God damn. You know, they dropping fucking missiles on individuals, babies dying, children's just blood everywhere. When that shit come to America, these people are going to freak the fuck out. Now it's happening in these different lands, and of course people freak out, but they're these other lands, they're used to seeing dead bodies. Like that's just part of their culture. It's dead body. They've been in war for years. Okay, so these people are like, it's going to be bad, of course, but it's not going to be to the level of America. These people are going to fucking freak out. Okay, they can't even tell you the definition of a woman. You get canceled if you say the wrong pronouns. Donald President is not even the president yet, and we not going to have sex with men. We going to cut my hair off. It's just bugged out. Right? It's just bugged out. I want to go back, actually, here. Let's go here. This is all fair use.
We begin the news hour with the war in Ukraine. The government in Kyiv saying Russia has used an intercontinental ballistic missile for the first time since Moscow launched its invasion in 2022. It says the missile targeted Dnipro City in the central east region of Ukraine. The Kremlin has refused to comment. Meanwhile, Ukraine reportedly fired 12 British-made cruise missiles into Russia's Kursk region on Wednesday. Moscow says it downed two of the missiles. It's the latest use of Western weapons on Russian targets. It comes a day after Ukraine fired U.S. missiles with Washington's approval. President Joe Biden has also authorized sending an anti-personnel mine force to Ukrainian forces. The Kremlin has accused Washington of trying to...
This is Esau, right? His blessing was a sword. You got you got mines and shit. They lay in mines and shit. They shoot missiles. They got drones. The Israelites are not doing this. This is Esau. Okay, so that's another. We don't have to watch all that. It's so many videos. You can watch it on your time. It's so many. Okay, but let me read this. Joel 3:9. Proclaim ye this among the Gentiles. Prepare war. Wake up the mighty man. Let all the men draw near. Let them come up. We've been speaking about this for years. Okay, and the Most High, he's hearing it. Because before the Heavenly Father does, and what does he do? He sends his prophets. And he literally gives you ample time to repent. But we know that Babylon cannot be healed. Okay, the scriptures say we would, what is that, Jeremiah 51st chapter? We would have healed Babylon, but Babylon is not healed. Forsake her. Okay. The writing is going to be on the wall. People are going to flee Babylon. You're going to have there's a lot of migrants coming in, but you're going to have a lot of people that have been here, these heathens, that's going to flee Babylon because it's going to get bad. You don't want to be stuck here in Babylon if you're not part of that number that's going to be delivered. You're going to be completely destroyed. Okay? So now the Heavenly Father is pretty much he told the heathen, prepare war. Get ready. It says, let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hook into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. So tools of agriculture, you know, building up your infrastructure, because what's the basis of how did people live beforehand? They lived off the earth. You had your plot of land and you would grow your shit and you would herd cattle and all that and goats and lambs and shit. Okay, but what now? We're in a different economy. We're in a different time where these governments, they're putting all their effort into killing instruments. To combat who? Really, America. But this is the Heavenly Father's will. That's his determination. Okay, assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen, and gather yourselves together round about. Thither cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord. And there's been more chariot sightings. Those mighty ones are the chariots which work on the minds of the people to do certain tasks. Okay, to put certain things in their head. All right, yeah, do this, do that. Yeah, we're going to be able to control it. Yeah, shoot this, shoot that. Esau is working tirelessly, okay? The scriptures tell you that. Thou art weary in the multitude of thy counsels. Because it's going to get out. It's going to get out of hand because it's never been in your hand. That's the point. It's always been in the hand of Yahweh Shemiah Shah. And you're going to understand that. Because you're going to, at the end of the day, Esau's thinking, okay, we're just going to flee into the bunkers, you know? We'll just flee into the bunkers and then we'll come out of the bunker and then we'll have our NWO. But that's not how it's going to roll. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen, and gather yourselves together round about. Thither cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord. Let the heathen be awakened and come up
come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat, for there will I sit to judge all the heathen round about. See? Put ye in a sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come, get you down. Basically, it's time. For the press is full, the fat overflows, for their wickedness is great. Multitudes, multitudes in the valley of decision, for the Lord, for the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. See that? The day of the Lord is near. Okay, and this, you know, is some, will something happen? Who knows? But we, what we do know is, it's coming. Okay, and don't take your mind, don't take your eye off what's going to happen in, you know, in the Middle East as well. That's all part of it. So the Most High is really just stirring up the host. He's the one who mustereth the host. Okay, so I'm gonna close there. It was just a little quick little video. Until next time, shalom to the elect.